every now and then we get a question that's really more of a brain teaser than anything else, like this one from Cindy Franco of New Canaan, Connecticut, who writes, you're driving along with a truck full of parakeets, right? And you hit a bump, sending all the birds into flight. Now, does the truck weigh less than it did when all the birds were sitting down? Does it weigh more? Does it weigh about the same? What do you think? Well, we've asked for professional help in answering this question, and any minute now, we're expecting Jack Netlin, physics teacher from Osseo High School, to arrive and give us a hand. Let's see if he's here yet. Wait, I think I hear Jack coming now. Follow me. Making a lot of noise out there. I wonder what's going on outside. What an entrance you made.
Thanks a lot, Doug. Thanks for the lift. Yeah, this is a hovercraft, Ira, and we're going to take a look at it.
What does a hovercraft have to do with birds in a truck?
Well, listen, we've got another one inside. Let's take a look at that. And as we go in there, I'll see if I can make some kind of connection between the two. Yeah, here we have it, Ira. A hovercraft, just like when we head out there. A lot quieter, of course.
We can hear each other. Now, this rides on a very small cushion of air, right?
Yeah, a cushion of air that's caused by air being pushed downward. And since you have that air being pushed downward hard enough, then it just equals the weight of the aircraft and our hovercraft and myself. And so now we are riding on a cushion of air. It equals that weight. The force downward equals the weight it goes, pushes it upward.
So then the hint I'm getting is that all flying things then must have some sort of pressure pushing down equal to the weight that's holding it up.
Exactly. The force downward has to equal their weight so that it goes upward. If it didn't, they'd fall.
Birds, too.
Birds, too. For example, we have some birds over here that we could imagine are flying through the air. If we give them a little impetus here, you can notice that they fly. Now, as they fly, their wings going up and down like this.
Right.
This one comes downward, and it pushes the air downward. Now, when it pushes the air downward, well, you have the bird being pushed up.
So there is a certain pressure that is being pushed down. I'm trying to get the clues together to answering that question.
Yes, I know. With the birds in the truck, you mean?
Right.
Yeah,
right.
It is kind of hard to see. But yeah, we've got force pushing down here. And in that truck, in that truck, you've got the same thing happen with lots of birds. Now, we have a very, very special bird we're firing up here to help see it even better.
This is a whirly bird we're talking about.
Yeah, a whirly bird.
A helicopter.
Isn't that neat?
That's great.
That's sitting there on a gigantic scale. This table it's sitting on, the weight of it will be registered right over here on this readout. Mm-hmm. Now, you can see it weighs about what?
About 6 pounds.
Now, what's going to happen is we're going to raise that right off the tabletop and have it hover there for a while.
Uh-huh.
Just like birds in a truck hovering there.
It's forcing wind down, just like a bird's wing.
And this will catch all that wind. This will catch all that wind. And it'll be measured over there. And what do you think it's going to measure when it gets up in the air?
Well, I have an idea, but let's find out.
Let's try and find out. Let's try it and see what happens. Okay, now the thing is starting up, lifting off the top. Little bit of rise. No, it's not touching the table anymore. Now, what does it still say?
It's still about 6 pounds.
Still about six pounds. Isn't that neat? And it's not touching it. Now he's going to take it and raise it over to the side. And now you can see the scale is doing what?
It's going way down.
Yeah, the scale's going way down because now it doesn't weigh anything.
Look at that.
That's it. Now he'll bring it back over the top of it and set it down. And now it's back, still weighing the same amount.
So it really did have a force of 6 pounds holding it up.
Even though it wasn't touching it,
So then our birds in a truck must be, with a truck, let's say, if it's 4 6 pounds, truck must weigh the same as when the birds...
Exactly the same, especially in that enclosed little truck where the air can't get off to the sides.
Mm-hmm.
So there it is.
Magnificent, Jack. Thank you very, very much for that air-raising explanation. We'll have more in just a minute.